Hi, my name is Umar Qureshi and I've always loved Aashiqui and I love Aashiqui 2. And now Aashiqui 2 is on release and the young and happening stars are here, Shraddha Kapoor, Aditya Roy Kapoor. So welcome the Kapoors.
Thank you.
We're going to talk about Aashiqui and we're going to have a lot of fun today.
Yes.
Welcome. You didn't try the Rahul Roy famous haircut.
Arey, we tried everything.
You tried that?
Normally the heroines look takes time, na? In 2 days, her look was sorted out.
His look took lots and lots and lots of time. He was actually the heroine of our film.
How much do you hate or love each other?
Oh, we're very good friends.
We have become good friends. Yeah. I'm just working
good
with someone
friends,
who...
like that definition.
Oh, acha, you're asking
good
like that?
Friends.
No,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, they're not good friends. They're like good friends. They're like good friends.
So tell me, guys, can I ask you a slightly personal question?
Of course.
To begin with, how old were you when the first Aashiqui released?
I think she was 9 and I was 5.
Okay, so. You were born. Like.
Yeah, we were born.
Okay.
You were born. I was just born.
Okay, I'm putting
and,
the age up.
And saw it later. Saw it in the 7th or 8th standard.
Okay.
Yeah.
You liked it?
I don't remember it much, but I remember liking it. And I remember enjoying it because it was a romantic film. You know, and because I've always loved romantic films, I'm crazy about them. Mm. And the songs are something that are still fresh in my mind. Yeah.
The songs are cult here.
They're a
movie is a cult film also.
It is really,
right.
Yeah.
But tell me, like, when you were offered the remake, both of you, like, what was your reaction? Joy?
It was joy. It was a daunting thing for me as well. This is my first solo lead thing and the whole thing. So for me to, I read this character is, on paper, it seems like quite a challenging character.
Hmm.
So for me, it was daunting. It was like, God, I didn't think about the whole Aashiqui franchise or anything. Yeah, I was just thinking about what I read.
Yeah.
So fear, excitement, and then, of course, joy.
Yeah, but you didn't try the Rahul Roy famous haircut.
Arey, we tried everything.
You tried that?
Normally, the heroine's look takes time, na?
Yeah.
She, in 2 days, her look was sorted out.
His
mine
look
took a month.
Took lots and lots and lots of time.
All kinds
he
of
was movies. Actually the heroine of our film.
Yeah. Okay, okay.
Yeah.
So I tried
and you had the locks.
No, I didn't. I had one lock on one side, so it's half one-sided lock.
Okay.
But he had a crazy hair, which had to be. I mean, you've probably seen it earlier in one of his films or whatever. So you're wondering, what do we do with that?
No. But we tried straight also, so we tried to replicate
tried a lot
the
of
whole
things.
Thing.
But
how different is this Aashiqui from the first?
I think it's completely different. This is a fresh take from Ansha Gupta's part. It's a there's a basic element of that crazy, blinding love, which is going to stay the same. So that basic intrinsic flavor is going to be there.
Yeah. But it's an original script.
It's an original script. It's different.
Original script. But you're aware of the fact that's a romantic movie and Rahul Roy and Anu Agarwal could not get along at all.
Hmm. Yeah, you just said that.
Hmm. Yeah, they could not. They made it very, very obvious.
Okay.
Yeah, on screen, it worked, the chemistry.
On screen, it worked then.
Yeah, but you guys, like, how much do you hate or love each other?
Oh, we're very good friends.
We have become good friends. We've become good friends.
Become what? It's not like we started on any
rough. Through the process, we got along from the word go only.
Okay.
So that's really good, yeah. It's good to work with someone you get along with, otherwise
life is hell, I can
imagine. It's so bad. Imagine working
good
with someone
friends,
you...
like that definition.
Oh, acha, you're asking
good
like that?
No.
We're not good friends. We're like good friends. We're like good friends.
Oh, buddy.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Aashiqui 2 songs are as popular now, getting as popular.
Right.
Yeah.
Way, slightly different from obviously Aashiqui 1, but what's the difference?
I think it's Mohit hasn't tried to replicate a sound of the past. He's tried to, in fact, take things forward in
new
a certain
sound.
Sense. For me, not that I'm a very a critic or someone to be able to have a professional opinion on this. I think Tumi was a song from another planet. Yeah. I think it's something which it's. It's slow. In this, it's not that processed electronic sound that we've come to hear with catchy one-liners and catchy phrases. It's something which is very simple.
Yeah.
The lyrics are simple and heartfelt, and it takes its time. It's like confident in itself.
One of my favorite tracks.
So I think in that sense, it's changing quite a bit.
It's not got that old school vibe, but it still retains that old flavor somewhere. You know, I can feel that flavor there.
And
I think that's what makes it really beautiful, the entire album.
Yeah. Are you romantic in real life, Shraddha?
Extremely.
Yeah? In what way?
In a lot of ways. In a lot of ways.
Look at her blush.
I know, every time someone asks me this question, I don't even need to put blush. My cheeks become pink. But I believe in that fairy tale-esque romance.
Okay.
And I would like to have that in my life at some point. Otherwise,
you don't?
let's just say अभी आशिकी से आशिकी हो रही है.
Okay. आशिकी से आशिकी.
But it'll be nice to have that. It'll be nice. Yeah. It'll be really nice.
That sweeping off your feet.
That man coming on that white horse.
Yeah.
Or now it's become a white Porsche.
It's changed. That's a good one.
Actually, I want the white horse. I want the white horse.
Okay. Is that a name of some brand?
No. I want the animal.
You're single
and,
right
and the man. As of now, let's just say that if there's somebody who comes with that fairy tale romance, then I will not be single.
You'll be open to it.
Mm. Yes. Mm.
You have a white horse?
Sorry? I have a white horse. I don't have a white Porsche, that's for sure. But a white horse, I can manage from somewhere.
Sounds obscene. Are you romantic?
I'm not romantic.
You're not
I've got a lot of complaints from ex-girlfriends in life about me being having to learn how to be a little more romantic.
A Scorpio man, not romantic.
Scorpions are supposed to be romantic?
Yeah, extremely passionate.
Oh, really?
God. So, yeah, I need to learn, yeah. But I think working in this love story has given me a few tips and taught me a little bit about myself also. So, yeah, I'm getting there.
Both of you come from like film backgrounds, you know, in very different ways. So, I mean, does that help you like be a little more confident than other newcomers?
Well, there is that non-stop advice at home, you know. There is that banter at home, which is always there, that filmy banter with my dad there and my Masi there. Yeah. So that is always there, and now my brother's movie is also releasing. So the house is a madhouse now. So even if nobody is really sitting down and giving you advice, because there's so much conversation, there's so many opinions floating around, that you gauge something, you learn something from that as well.
Right.
So I think it's a great thing. Yeah, it's a wonderful thing to be brought up in a film family.
And
helpful.
For me, it's different because the three of us have now found ourselves in the industry. We never grew up talking or being part of the film industry. Even Siddharth, I think, just when Rang De Basanti is the time that he got into the industry as well.
Wow, so, that reason.
Yeah, so all three of us have somehow found our way into this place right now. And now we're finding that we are a filmy brother-in or whatever.
Family, yeah.
Yes. So now we're talking about is film, and my parents are very puckered at the dinner table saying, talk about something else, guys.
Yeah.
But we're in it now.
But is it true that, I mean, you've got a filmy sister-in-law in Vidya. You pull her leg a lot and you tease her a lot.
I don't tease her a lot. I get teased. Yeah, I'm the youngest, so there's no dearth of that. But we all have a lot of fun, and I guess,
She gives you any acting tips?
Not consciously. I'm happy that she doesn't think that she doesn't need to give me too many, but that's a good thing.
That's
otherwise,
a good thing.
If she thought I would, I'm sure she would sit me down and say, Aditya, you'd better learn. I'm putting a camera on you. But we all talk about film all the time. I think with someone like her, who I really do admire so much, it's important to just listen and to imbibe that work ethic, you know.
She's
and a certain way they carry themselves and handle themselves.
Yeah.
That's something to learn from because she's gone through a crazy
she's
career.
She's amazing.
Wonderful.
You have a lot of female fans and they want to know whether you're single or dating.
I am single. Where are all of you? Because I don't see all these female fans.
There was talk of someone called Rhea.
No, she's just a good friend of mine and someone said you all went shopping together. Every girl you go shopping together, you can't be dating. I'll be dating a lot of girls.
Are there shades of Abhiman in the movie? Apparently, they say the Amitabh Bachchan's Abhiman, the shade.
I really need to watch this film because people are asking me and I keep saying I've not watched it. And then they say, you're a fool for not having watched
it. There are no similarities between the two, no.
Nothing?
No.
Where she becomes better than him at what he does.
There's a similarity in a basic theme. But I don't think the whole dynamic of the film is the same. The treatment is different.
The stories are different.
2013 version of things. So maybe it's different.
Okay. How did the casting of this one happen?
Well, luckily we weren't auditioned. Let's just put it as that.
So our thing is, if we were auditioned, we might not be here.
We wouldn't have got the film. So luckily we were not auditioned, and Mohit saw our previous films, and based on that, and he met us as well. Yeah. So I think that's how he cast us.
Mohit says this movie is like Mahesh Bhatt said. This is made for Mohit, you know, and he's done wonderfully well. Apparently, we are looking forward to the film. What do you think of him as a director?
He's a wonderful guy. Yeah. He's really a great guy. He's all heart, you know.
Yeah. He's all heart. Yeah.
He says that, you know, I don't care about putting up some round trolley or this and that and my shots looking good if you guys and the actor and the emotion of it is not working. So that I think some films, it don't matter how it looks, if the actors are feeling what they're doing and the story has some weight in it, that's all that matters. And he's the kind of guy, if you give a good shot, he's smiling the rest of the day, it goes well. And if you don't, you know,
he's just happy so long as you're feeling what you're doing, and that translates on
and
screen.
And that comes out in some
and it comes
kind,
out.
Yeah. Some
it comes
energy.
Out.
Yeah. You have a lot of female fans, and they want to know whether you're single or dating.
I am single. Where are all of you? Because I don't see all these female fans.
There was talk of someone called Rhea.
No, she's just a good friend of mine, and someone said you all went shopping together. Yeah. So every girl you go shopping together, you can't be dating. You'll be dating a lot of girls.
So you do the shopping.
Then you would be.
Was it Valentine's Day?
Oh no, it wasn't.
Oh yeah, I forgot. You're not romantic.
I'm not.
What are your expectations now of yourself after your first two movies? Like, you took a breather and you said, "Okay, now I take a breather. Now what?"
Now what? Right. So that breather was actually quite nice. You know, I was reading some stuff and there were some scripts that were offered to me. And nothing that I felt that I could really give my life for, you know. And then when I met Mohit and then he told me about Aashiqui, it's something that I felt that I also grew up a little bit in that time frame. So I felt that Aashiqui came at the right time for me. And I felt that emotionally, I was ready for it. So the timing was perfect.
But tell me, a movie like this, a passionate love story, needs a lot of intensity. And once again, where do you draw from that intensity from within?
Where do you draw from? I think you only draw from your past experiences, the relationships you've had, the things you felt when things have gone wrong or things have felt really nice. What you felt like when you were young and you fell in love with some girl in the 8th standard, you know, that pure feeling of, that's what you draw from. But I don't know if every actor is different to each his own. Yeah. Every actor has a different way of doing things. Some try and recall a certain incident and get into their mind frame.
From somebody else's experience?
From their own experience. Okay. So maybe you broke up in the 9th standard and you remember what you felt like and you feel that and you go into the scene. But for me, it's different. I don't know if I do it unconsciously. Yeah. I don't know. Would you?
You?
Same thing. I think somewhere from life experiences, somewhere from moments that you've gone through. But there were actually moments on this film particularly where I felt connected with the character so much as well. And sometimes the emotion just comes out like right then and there. Maybe you don't really have to dig up something. Sometimes when you're so emotionally close to a character, you can actually feel and empathize with what the character is feeling sometimes.
What experience in the past, sorry?
So those are magical moments actually when that happens.
But you said you've not been in a relationship, so then where do the past experiences come from?
They can come from a lot of other places. You don't have to be in a fairy tale relationship. They can come from a lot of other experiences.
Right, like watching movies, like watching Aashiqui 1, right?
Yeah.
Of course.
And Notebook and
of course.
It's okay to check out other men when you're in a committed relationship.
It's okay to appreciate them. It's okay to say that they're cute and just leave it there.
Okay, leave it.
That's it.
And for you?
Yeah, I think it's the same thing. Look but don't touch.
Okay, guys, I'm going to ask you a quick fire question round right now. Let's see how we do.
Let's do it.
When you look at a woman, what's the first thing you notice?
It depends which woman, but I think...
quick!
Okay. You notice her hair.
And when you notice a guy?
His personality.
Personality?
Yes.
Okay. Looks don't matter.
Looks also matter. So then, in that term, it would be his face.
How old were you when you first realized you were in love?
I don't know if I ever realized that, but when I thought I was in love, I think I was 18.
You?
Was also probably around 16, 17, I felt. Yeah.
Your first kiss was?
I think in the 8th.
Yours?
I think my 7th.
Yeah? Always late, always late.
What to do,
Do you think that physical attributes are important in sustain a relationship?
I think the physical side of things is important as well. But I think in a long relationship, that obviously fades away.
Yeah.
In a certain sense.
Yeah.
It'll be nice to have someone like that with six-pack abs and broad shoulders and a hunk. Why not? Yeah. I mean, it'll be nice to have that. But I think eventually, love surpasses all that as well. But it'll be nice to have that also.
Yeah. It's okay to check out other men when you're in a committed relationship.
It's okay to appreciate them. It's okay to say that they're cute and just leave it there.
Okay, leave it.
That's it.
And for you?
Yeah, I think it's the same thing. Look but don't touch.
Look but don't touch.
Yeah, that's the saying.
Temptation?
is always going to be there. It's a human trait.
It's a human trait. Yeah. Do you think public display of affection is okay, PDA?
Well, if two of you are in a relationship and you're all celebrities, then please don't do that. But
it's unfortunate, but
it's unfortunate.
Yeah,
but why not? Yeah, I mean, yeah, but there's a degree to it.
Yeah,
there's some decorum to it. You can't go a little
you can't go making
crazy
completely.
Right.
What about you?
Yeah, I think to a degree, you have to know to draw the line.
Are you an extremely physical person in a relationship?
Physical in the sense, well, yeah, I guess
can't
so.
Keep your hands off.
I guess.
Yeah, and you?
I feel like I'm quite affectionate. Like I want to keep like
hugging him.
Hugging and holding. Yeah.
Okay, but guys, I can see that you guys are in the mood for some aashiqui. Yeah, and
really?
I think everyone here has got into the mood for some aashiqui too.
Uh-huh.
So, looking forward to the movie. Thank you for this amazing
chat.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.